Hello everyone, and welcome to a new IBMI RPG sample video. Today I'm going to talk to you about how to detect the possible errors that we may receive when we execute SQL statements embedded in our RPG programs. Let's go. In my last video, I told you that by using a monitor statement, we can detect any error in the program, but that is not completely true. If you're getting an error because of an SQL statement, it will be not detected by the monitor. To do this, we need to use two variables that are always present in our programs with embedded SQL code. These are SQLCOD and SQLSTATE. For making the example, I have prepared a simple table named price2 with this content. Let me show you. Price2. Well, as you can see, we have an item identifier, a price, and a special discount. Okay, let me show you now a small example program that I have prepared where I am retrieving information from this table. Okay, as you can see, it is a very simple program. It only retrieves the price of a specific item from the table, in this case, the ID number 5, calculates the price, and displays it. I haven't added any error checking because I want to show you how it works. If I run the program, you will see what happens. Let me compile it. Okay. And let me go to the green screen. And as you can see, the price for ID number 5 is 2.44. Well, as you can see, the ID number 5, the price is 2.6. But if I am applying the special discount, I will retrieve this other number. Okay, so it works perfectly. But now imagine that someone, for example, has deleted the price file from our library by mistake. What would happen if then I run the program? Well, let's do it. Let's change the name, for example, for this table to prices2x. Okay, so prices2 is not present anymore. So what happened if I run the program again? Well, as you can see, I don't get any error. And well, this is very bad. Why? Because this would be a very dangerous mistake. Imagine it is a program that bills our customers and we are billing our items at zero. That would be very bad, okay? The price for ID 5 is zero. Okay, also I have added to my program if you can see here, I am sending these two values to the job log, SQL code and SQL state. And if you see, I'm getting this value for SQL code and this value for SQL state. Okay, so let me change the program again. Let's try, change the name of the file again to prices2. Okay, now the program will run correctly as before. But now imagine that I'm checking for a different ID, an ID that doesn't work, that doesn't exist. For example, this one, okay? If I compile the program again and I run it, I'm not getting an error, I'm getting a price of zero. And if I see, in this case, I'm getting these two values, this for SQL code and this for SQL state. Okay? Well, so this is all a possible error, checking for the price of an ID that doesn't exist. In that case, the program is running in the same way without giving any error. So how can we detect all these errors? Okay, let's try adding a monitor statement. I know it is not going to work, but I want to show you that it actually doesn't work. Let's add it here, for example, at the beginning. Okay. Error detected. Okay, let me compile it. Okay. And let's run it again. As you see, I'm not getting errors and I'm not getting the message. I'm not getting this message. Okay, so as I said before, the monitor statement is not working. So what can we do? Well, let's introduce SQL code and SQL state. Okay. Well, as you have seen, I'm sending these two values to the job log, but I'm not using them. Let me remove the monitor. Here too. Okay. Well, SQL state. SQL state is a 5-character global variable that identifies the nature of the error. The two first characters indicate the error class. For example, if we get a 0-1 class error, it means that I have received a warning. Okay. In addition, we have SQL code that is an integer value. This value will be a negative number if there has been any error. A warning will give a positive number. So SQL code will be 0 in other case. This doesn't mean that SQL code must be always 0, because for example, if you have a loop reading a cursor, SQL code will not be 0 when you finish going through the entire cursor. But, well, this is not an error that may close the program, okay? You can see all the possible values for these two variables in the IBM documentation here in this page, okay? For example, as you see, in this case, I was receiving 100 for SQL code, and it means one of the following errors occurred. Okay. And this is the same as this value for SQL state. Okay. And 0-2 is this class code, no data. Well, okay. Let's add the SQL code check to the program. For example, we can do this. Remember that this check needs to be done after the execution of the SQL statement. Okay, if we have another different SQL statement between this one and this check, this is not the value that is returning this execution, only the last. Okay, well, if we are getting this this value different than 0, let's see if SQL code is less than 0, then error retrieved retrieving, sorry, price for ID. Okay. And if it is a positive number, it is going to be a warning. Okay. And if in both, and in both cases, it's a return. Okay. Let's compile it and let's run it. Okay, and as you see, I have a warning retrieving price for ID 85. This is a warning, okay? And the warning is because I have received this code, this SQL code. That means that I have no data received, okay? If the file doesn't exist in the system and I run the program there, then I'm not receiving a warning, I'm receiving an error. So as you see, these are two different errors, okay? Well, of course, the correct way is to check every SQL code depending on the possible error that we can receive for every different SQL statement. Okay, so I hope you like this video. Please keep a like. If so, don't forget to subscribe. And you have, and if you have any question or something about this, please leave your comment below. And thanks for watching.